And now we will learn how to bill clients for expenses that they cause us to have. First, you have to pay the expense yourself the way you would write a check or enter a bill when you record your expenses normally. But when you do that, you will mark the expense as billable. That's different than the way we showed it in the previous videos. If you mark it as billable, you can then put it later on an invoice when you bill the client. Now, it might check the billable check mark automatically. You would have to take a look at the defaults in the preferences window and decide, do you want the check mark for billable to come up automatically every check and every bill, or do you want to put it yourself? So let's take a look. From the main menu, we click Edit, Preferences. Now there are different categories of preferences, but the category of preference that we need in this case is all the way at the bottom. You scroll all the way down and you click the category of time and expense. Then you click the company preference tab. There's a little check mark here in this box. Mark all expenses as billable. If you leave it, it means every time you open the write a checks window or the enter bills window, you will see the check mark is placed and it will assume you will bill a client later. If you remove this, it means the check mark will not automatically be there and you will have to place the check mark yourself. I suggest you remove it because most expenses will not be billable to clients and you don't want to have to bother keeping to remind yourself that you have to remove the check mark. So we click OK and we won't have to worry about that. For example, let's imagine on April 1, we paid Rex Repair $200 for fixing the door that Betty broke when she threw a fit in the office. We will later add this expense to the very next invoice that we sent her when we eventually bill her for future legal services. What will happen when we record this check? Well, our repair expense will go up when we pay it because it is an expense to us at the moment we pay it, because we have not yet gotten reimbursed. If we have not yet gotten reimbursed and we have not yet billed it to the client, it's our expense at the moment we pay it. However, at the moment we put that expense on the bill to the client, the repair expense will go down. Our repair expense will go down and the client's balance will go up at the moment we put it on a bill or an invoice to the client. That means that they're responsible for it, so we no longer have that expense at the moment that it's put on the bill. So let's take a look at how to do this transaction. Well, it's the same like writing any other check if you happen to have it in your icon bar, and the date was April 5th of 2017. Excuse me, I think it was April 1st. Yes, April 1st of 2017. This is not a joke. Okay, April 1 of 2017, make sure you have the right year there. And you don't have to print the check. You don't have, you know, you can watch the supplemental videos about check numbers or printing. We're not going to deal with that. But the people whom we write the check to are Rex Repair. Now, I forgot to put Rex Repair on the list, so we could add him on the fly. Add new, vendor, click OK, in capital letters. Type Rex Repair, and then you'll have Rex Repair on your vendor list. Now, what expense is this? Now, did I put repair expense? I didn't actually put repair expense, but we can add it now. It's called adding a list item on the fly. By the way, anytime you're looking through a list item, through a list, and you don't see the one you're looking for, you can scroll all the way up and you can click Add New. And you can add a new expense or a new account right there at the moment you record the transaction. Repair expense. So now we have the correct vendor and the correct expense, and we have the correct money amount, $200. And most importantly, in the bottom right, you have to choose the correct customer. Notice, now that we chose a customer or a job, the billable box came up. And also notice the check mark did not come there automatically. Why is that? Because we changed the default in the preferences window a moment ago. However, in this case, we are going to bill this to Betty in the future. So we click the billable box, and then we're going to click the save and close button here. And now when we open up the profit and loss by client, you can see for Betty, we have $200 of repair expense. Now look what happens when we actually bill Betty. The next time we send her an invoice will be April 5th. And we're going to bill her for the $800 of legal services that we did, plus the $200 in repairs that she caused. So we're going to open an invoice window just like the way we would in a normal case. And of course, we have to put the date April 5th, 2017. The client is Betty. Don't worry about this. This that just popped up here is the most important pop-up. It is not a false pop-up. It is part of the process. You have to select the outstanding billable time or cost. You see, what happened was, let's take a look at what happened here. As soon as we chose Betty, when we opened the invoice window, as soon as we chose Betty, QuickBooks said, oh, you have billable items for Betty. Would you like to add one of these to the invoice? And you're supposed to click OK. And when you click OK, you get this window. Choose billable time and cost. If you had timesheets for your lawyer associates, they would all be listed here, and you could put them right on the invoice of that particular client. But in this case, we have expenses. We have one particular expense on the list of expenses that are billable for Betty. By the way, attorneys are not allowed to mark up their expenses when they bill their clients. You have to bill the clients for the amount that you paid if it's a billable expense and not a legal service. So all you have to do is click the check mark in the left margin of which particular expenses you're putting on the invoice. In this case, there's only one. So when we click OK, you will now notice that this $200 is on this invoice. Now on the next row, you will put your normal legal services rendered and the amount of legal services rendered in this case was 800. So in this invoice, the income will go up by 800 and the specific expense will decrease by 200. When we click save and close, okay, just click cancel for this. Click save and close. Click OK. Okay, what sometimes happens is the stupid email button is clicked here and you can't save the invoice, so you remove it, save and close. Do not apply credits. We talked about that later. And now when we look, we can see that repair expense for Betty is down to zero. Why is repair expense down to zero? Let's take a look. Double click. Well, it went up when we wrote a check to for Rex repair, but then our repair expense went down when we put it on an invoice. The moment you put the expense